The Surrealist Object. This is the Surrealist Object speaking to the British public. It has become necessary for the object to explain themselves to the people. For convenience, I speak on behalf of other objects. What is a Surrealist Object? It is an idea. What a good idea, people say, when something occurs to them, when something appeals to their imagination. How do such ideas come? It is often hard to say. Suddenly or gradually, they are part of our consciousness. Awake or asleep, we become aware of them. Where then do they come from? Some people say, confidently, out of the unconscious. Others will tell you, from the world of dreams. Others, again, speak only of poetry. We need not go into that. It is more important to realize by what act objects come into being, because the nature of the act partly determines the character of the object. But first of all, there is one act without which no object can come to life. This is the act of imagination. Every object in the room is imagined. The other acts of finding, interpreting, dreaming, or otherwise realizing the object, giving it character, are responsible for the different categories you find in the catalogue. First, consider the found object. Surely, you might say, an object which is found cannot be concerned with an act of the imagination. On the contrary, it is found by that means. By finding it, you create it. What is more, it has always been yours, but hidden from your consciousness until the accident of your perception gives it birth. Next, interpretive objects. These partly explain themselves. But interpretation may be of two kinds: the completion of one idea or the creation of another out of new elements. Number 45, Chesil Beach Engine, represents the first very clearly. Number 50, the pilot's cutter, is a good instance of the second. A perturbed object is one that has suffered some violent aggression, such as being charred or melted in a fire or struck by lightning. Number 93, burnt offering, shows a remnant of furniture amazingly perturbed. It has become a black flower. An oniric object is a dream object of a particular kind. Most object dramas of dreams are what is called wish fulfillments, but some seem to be pure fantasy, dreams within dreams, as it were. It is a subtle difference, not easy to distinguish. Look, for instance, at the Mexican water clock. This brings us to the Surrealist Object, which title covers all other objects in this exhibition in greater or less degree, including the collage or object pictures. The Surrealist Object appears to be more an act of will than an act of chance. Many are elaborate constructions, but you can see they are the product of ideas which spring from the imagination, and many are wittily expressed, especially in their titles. People have often asked two questions: why do the objects have such titles, and why are so many objects disquieting or perverse? These people forget the dream. In making surrealist objects, there is always the influence of the dream. That is why they so often appear like things seen in sleep, when we inhabit an irrational world. How often then do we encounter strange objects in unlikely associations and hear tantalizing phrases which seem full of meaning? Do not these objects here and their titles remind you of those dream adventures? Listen. It is Rococo Cocotte speaking. Angel of Anarchy, mute in two moods. Homes without hands. Homes without hands. This is a machine for making clouds, and I'm a virgin washerwoman. But the caged bunyip sang, the big bird dies in town. The same inconsequence and fantasy pervade the other objects here. The dew machine, for instance, the guaranteed fine weather suitcase, or the basket for found objects, and the disconcerting present from Man Ray. But above all, these objects are alive. You cannot look at long gone Pa and say he is no more than a piece of furs. No, he is a personality. The spirit which animates Mopo Miro from Easter Island lives again in this room. Here, magic is trapped for a while. Yet do not think that when you leave this room, you will leave magic behind. You will not go alone. These objects will follow you. Their peculiar beauty will haunt you. And either you will acquire one to keep the others off, or you will come again.